All right, so on YouTube, I am here at my hotel, outside by the pool there. And it's gonna be a little bit different of a video today. So if you guys are here for the fitness content, before we get into it at all, if you guys are here for like the fitness, for the business, and you know, all that type of stuff, this may not be the video to watch. And so maybe wait till the next one. But though my channel is like based around those things, my personal life is integrated into every single video. You see my friends, you see my relationships, you see my family, you see Nala, Knox, you see Ava, you see everything, right? And I've been on YouTube since I was 19 years old. I'm about to turn 24 this coming month, and I've obviously been through a lot of life changes. And recently, I've experienced a very big life change, and you guys see the title, you know what this is about, right? But before I get into it, I just want to say that I feel like I've had the tendency in the past, when big life changes, when personal things happen to me, that I don't really want to talk about, but I feel like I need to talk about. I've been very straightforward, very, very broad. I don't like giving detail. I don't like talking too much about it. I just want to kind of like say what needs to get done, like say what I need to say, sum it up, give you guys a summary, and then like move on with the content and everything. But this is a really big change, and I'm gonna take the next few minutes to sort of just fill you in and get you caught up to speed, leave everything on the table, and be honest with you guys, transparent. It's a big goal of mine this year, and so I'm gonna open up, all right? Here we go. For the last few months, I've been seeing somebody, and her name is Heidi. You guys may not know her. I've collabed with her before. She's on YouTube, social media, this whole thing, right? And she's an amazing girl. Now, Heidi and I first hung out, I guess. We had a group that went to Austin. And so it was like me, it was Siobhan, it was Daniel, who else was it? It was Heidi, it was her best friend Lexi, it was Shali, you know, Becca went. We literally had a group of like, I want to say 8 or 9 people go to Austin, and we all hung out. We went canoeing, had a whole day in Austin, we went out that night, and it was a group setting. This is late October. It went really well. Heidi and I sort of started talking after that trip. And one thing I want to say is like, literally, we did that trip and Lexi had posted a Snapchat. And me and Heidi were in the background of the Snapchat. And Lexi didn't notice. We were like riding bikes. Everyone was riding bikes, having a great time. And it was like screenshot and sending in all these gossip pages. And literally like day one of hanging out with me in a group setting, there was already like all like right, and there's been a lot of pressure on us since literally day one of even like hanging out in a group, and it's been a lot, you know. I'm a real person, Heidi's a real person. We get stressed out about these things, you know, if we see like freaking get blown up in negative comments and all this stuff, and it's like, you know, you sideline it, but we're real people. It's hard to hear that stuff, and especially like dating someone new, and just like we weren't even dating. We were just literally in a group environment, and then you know we started talking and hanging out more, like making trips. She lives in San Antonio, I live in Houston. It's about a 3-hour drive, so like I would drive to San Antonio for 1 or 2 days. She would drive here to Houston, and we'd go back and forth over the next few months. And like we've done some trips together. We stayed in New York for the New York retreat. We stayed, I think, one day after. I surprised her with a Pittsburgh ticket. She's a big fan of the Penguins, so we went to a Pittsburgh game, front row, like amazing. We've done all these cool things, right? But throughout these last few months, it hasn't been like, we haven't been trying to be shady or be liars or like hide these things. We've literally been taking time like normal people to get to know each other before opening up and like letting millions judge us, right? And judge our actions and decisions, like what we're doing, what we're saying. And it's just a lot to deal with. It's a lot of pressure. And I feel like there's not many, I don't know, it's crazy. But we hung out in Austin with the group. From there, like I said, we started, you know, doing commuting trips and really, really enjoying each other's company. We have a lot in common. A few things about Heidi. She is like a beast worker. She has such a good work ethic. She runs her own business. She has okay, so I'm recording in 4K using a little camera. I think it ran out of space or something. So I'm gonna pick up. And so we went on the Austin trip, and it was great. You know, we kind of got to know each other. We talked a little bit. We actually had like one-on-one conversation, which we had never had in the history of knowing her. I have known Heidi for about 3 years or so, and we've never like been one-on-one. We've never anything like that. So it was really nice. And it's starting to rain. But after that, we would commute. I would drive to San Antonio. She would come to Houston, like I said, back and forth. And you know, we would do trips and stay extra and do all these cool things. And you know, I'm a daily vlogger. Even if I don't upload every day, I record every single day. It's starting to rain. It's really cold. But it's been really hard to kind of cut everything. You know, I can't record this. I can't record for like 3 days in a row or 2 days in a row. And it gets difficult. I feel like that's been hard for me to do. And we both decided that we're ready to open up to you guys. I'm really happy. So happy right now, honestly, guys. Like, there's nothing really more for me to say, but she's a great girl, and I hope that you guys can trust my judgment. If I'm coming to you guys willing, if I'm like talking about this on my channel, it's something great. So I'm really excited to, you know, continue getting to know her, and we have committed to each other, and so I'm just excited to see where that goes, to see where life goes, see where everything goes. And it's just, same Christian, same everything. Just a new chapter. So I'm really excited about this. And though the pressure was a lot, I think that the constant pressure, man, like the last week or two, we haven't really cared too much about, say, like Snapchatting the same place or, you know, kind of like whatever. But the first few months, it was very stressful for both of us. And especially I was more stressed for her. It was just like so much on her. And I think it's gonna be really nice to kind of like verbalize this and let this out and let her side out and all this stuff. And the big picture is that we're very happy right now. And I'm very happy. So if I'm happy, everything's good, you know, and I'm really excited for it. So hopefully I can have you guys' support. It would mean a lot to me. And, you know, if who I'm dating makes or breaks, you know, the fact of supporting or not, then you know it's all good. Like, no hard feelings at all, but I'm just really excited for everything that's coming, and I hope that you guys are too. So enjoy this vlog. Like I said, a lot of fitness business stuff. I head back to Houston tomorrow. I fly in at 7:30 in the morning, and got a lot of stuff to catch up on for this weekend, so that's all coming to you guys. But sit back, relax, enjoy this video. Whew! Good. Alright, so we just discussed the, I guess, announcement video, right?
Yeah.
And how are you feeling right now?
I feel good.
Feel good?
I like it. Weight is being lifted off of our shoulders.
And we were highly considering waiting until what, next week?
Yeah. No more.
No more.
Just get it out.
It's too much stress.
Too much stress.
Pressure.
You don't need that. You don't need the stress.
It's been months and months of stress. So, we can get over with. We're gonna do it. We're gonna do it live and be done. Yeah?
Yeah. Feel good.
So this is the very first clip probably, maybe, ever?
Yeah.
Wow. Wow. And for the last few hours, we've been here at Venice Beach. It's the last day here in LA. And so we've just been like, you know, hanging out. Did a lot of the swings, the rings. We did some muscle ups, some of the walking on. We walked on the tightrope.
I walked on the tightrope.
Heidi walked on the tightrope. I did not walk on the tightrope. I got up though.
You did okay.
I got up. And yeah, we're going to the gym, or are we going to chill? We could work out at Gold's. Let's work out at Gold's tonight, yeah?
Yeah.
All right, so get you leggings, yeah?
Yeah.
All right, here's chilling brushes. Let's go. Let's walk all the way to the thing, we'll rinse our feet off and shoes, yeah?
Perfect.
Perfect. Actually, where the pier is, I think if you walk this way, there's a Lulu. I'm like 85% positive, and a Nike store.
Oh.
You know which one I'm talking about?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
I forgot my card actually, so Heidi's being sugar mama today. Right, you're being sugar mama?
Am I going to be your sugar mama?
Yeah, I really don't like feet.
I don't either.
They're so disgusting. Oh. You have to manually adjust the lens.
Oh, like this?
Yeah.
Come on.
Sharp.
Maybe? No, wait, let me see. There it is.
Heidi and I have been brainstorming this intro to this video for like the last hour. Just kind of thinking. I'm fed up. Happy.
Yeah.
Alright, that's it. Two words, intro song, play the clip. But I have to record it still, so I don't know where or when I'm gonna record it.
I love the idea of like,
it's like the behind, this is like the
layer.
It's like a
bunch of layers.
The pre announcement.
I'm glad we're doing this when I'm sick.
Yeah, Heidi sounds like a man right now.
Hey! You look good.
You look better. You look better. Isn't that a thing?
Yeah.
You look good, huh? You look better.
I'm sorry, I'm loving Benny Carmelini. Is that you,
too? Open eye. Feel the waves cut through me. Hypnotized by the sounds I'm breathing in. Hold tight, hold tight. Chemicals collide. Hold tight, hold tight. Hold tight. Dripping lights paint the skies. All because of you. Dripping lights paint the skies. Only you.
Jane, which is kind of like a Lulu. I think they've been around a decent amount of time, definitely over 5 years, right across from True Foods. And now, just waiting, I already called an Uber. We're gonna head to Gold's Gym Venice. I'm gonna hit a leg day. Oh yeah, leg day. Yes, getting amped up for it. So here, I need a pre-workout, man. I'm gonna go find some source of caffeine. So wake up, and then go.
Leave me alone.
Is it real?
It looked cool. Good transition. How was your thumb workout in between your sets? Because I saw you doing a thumb workout too.
I'm not as warmed up as you are. Check it out, this movement. I don't have one of these at the gym, and not a lot of gyms actually have this piece of machinery, right? But I just did my first set, my legs are on fire. I feel like I'm hitting parts of my hamstring on glutes that never really hit because it's angled. And like right when I lifted it off, my back just, so it feels really good. But I'm just gonna keep my legs up here. Let shoulder width and stuff, and try to keep my lower, my entire back on the bench as much as possible. Yeah. Well, my feet are pointed slightly outwards. I to keep the weight on my heels as much as possible. I'm just doing this to exaggerate, but this should be onto the heel. Grab on, come down. Pause. So 3 second down, 3 to 4 second. Pause, one Mississippi, two Mississippi. Everything we're doing today, we're pretty much 3 to 4 second negative coming down, right? Squeeze, so 3 to 4 second negative, pause at the bottom or squeeze, depending on what you're doing, for 1 to 2 seconds, and then explode up. So in this instance, you're pushing up on the hamstring curl, you're pulling down. The negative's just like the release of the movement, so the bringing down of the movement. And then the exertion is the positive of the movement. We're gonna do like 4 to 5 sets of everything today.
Yes, repeat it. I'm sorry. I have buttery fingers and so it slips off the record button.
I'll never notice it.
Tell me.
I'm dating. Oh. I'm nervous. My legs really fatigued.
It's angles.
Oh, secret announcement, another announcement. We're gonna host like an outdoor gym party very soon in Houston. Like later this month in January, so it's gonna be big. Are you coming?
For me? Those angles though.
Disgusting thing in the last one. Heidi didn't record it. I don't know.
So now you have to do it again. You have to do it again. I dare you to do it again.
With a dare.
I dared him to lick the barbell. Do it.
And I'm gonna get a lot of.
Do it for the YouTube. Thumbs up if you.
Oh, that was
no,
a lot.
No, I didn't see it. I didn't get
literally,
a close up. I didn't
time?
Get a close up. Do it. You have to do it so they can see. Really close up. Hold on. Do it. Ew, Christian, this is why you get sick. You just did it 3 times.
That was like a 3 second hold.
I
did it 3 times.
Gross.
Before I get like a black tongue.
Stay away from me. I feel like you have diseases.
Last set. I've done 2 sets of 7, so I'm gonna try 7 again.
I'm gonna give you a thumbs up for doing that because that was pretty gross.
That is the worst film work ever.
sets at least.
Five sets.
You have to like work out for me since I'm sick and I can't work out.
Day one, wearing these shoes. Stepped in a massive puddle of mud. Yeah, pretty typical.
How dare you wear your shoes outside?
How dare I not look where I'm walking? Sorry, excuse me.
We both look scary.
I look...
You look extra scary. You look extra.
You look as ugly as you can.
I'm sick. I already look ugly.
So, we're just talking. It's kind of a unique way to record, right?
Yeah, this is cool. We should do more often.
Yeah.
The lighting.
We're just talking, and competition's gonna be June 4th, right? Here in California, in Sacramento, actually. So I'm thinking about doing my last few weeks of prep in California, maybe here in Venice. I don't know how far, probably a few hour drive, but I don't know. It's north, for sure.
North?
I see what you did there. Probably like a 3-4 hour, I don't know. Anyway, doing the last few weeks of prep here in California, like really getting in the zone and just killing it, and then driving up north to do the show. But yeah, exciting. Just thoughts, you know?
Do
head
it.
Back to the hotel.
Do it.
This is our last like long Uber. We've been in so many Ubers the last few days.
LAX might be kind of far, right?
Is it far? Oh, that's what there is. I think it's like 20 minutes. 25.
Oh, okay.
My flight's at 7:50.
How far is this trip?
This is 39 minutes. Yeah, 39.
I'm taking a nap.
Okay, we'll see you guys at the house. Don't look in the light, Bob. Don't do it. Secret flavor of protein. Secret flavor of protein number two. I guess this isn't even exciting because like you'll get, I don't know. I'm going to try them. I'm going to test them out and give my opinion to Ghost. But yeah, this one's a big deal. And this one, one hint. Oh my gosh.
I want to try this.
Heidi's feeling super sick.
I still want to try this.
Heidi's on that good.
I feel great.
She slept for like 40 minutes in the car. Snored the whole way.
I did not snore.
How do you know if you did or not?